This is the SAP Developer News for October 3rd, 2024.
In any software project, there are best practices to which, ideally, developers will adhere. I'm talking about things like code readability and maintainability, code standards and style guidelines, quality and security. Now, a linter is the ideal tool for checking for and gently but firmly enforcing these best practices. Now, back in March of this year, the UI5 linter was announced in a blog post from Oliver. Now, the initial version still had lots of gaps, but it was warmly received by the developer community, who gave lots of feedback, which was in turn gratefully received and incorporated into the tool. Now, earlier this week saw the official 1.0 release of the UI5 linter. This 1.0 release adds more problem detections, including use of deprecated framework components and APIs, and also old style manifests and deprecated library usage. Now, of course, the linter, even at 1.0, is still not quite complete, but the team are working hard on the items which they've put onto a roadmap. All it takes to get going with the UI5 linter is a quick npm install global of the UI5 linter package, and you're off to the races. By the way, talking of roadmaps, the latest SAP UI5 roadmap has been released. This roadmap covers the developments that are planned for the rest of this year, but also for the first two quarters of 2025. The roadmap covers items in the area of SAP Fiori development, UX consistency, UI controls, and more. So head on over to the roadmap area to check it out.
I can't believe we've already covered two full weeks of Devtoberfest. It's been great to see so many people joining the educational sessions, completing tutorials, tracking their progress on the game board, and overall interacting with each other on the community. Now, after just the first 5 days of Devtoberfest, we already had over 20,000 unique viewers on the content of Devtoberfest. That's a great chunk of the community coming out to enjoy all this Devtoberfest content. And over half of those, 20,000, had never watched any video on the SAP Developers YouTube channel. So maybe we have some new viewers here watching the developer news for the first time. If so, that's you. Welcome, and I hope you stick around and enjoy more news that we bring you every week on this channel. Now, Devtoberfest is taking a slight pause here. We had the first 2 weeks of Devtoberfest. Next week is SAP TechEd. We have the virtual TechEd taking place on Tuesday and Wednesday. The developer advocates will be live from Germany doing the developer keynote deconstructed, as well as bringing you special episodes of the developer news on this channel at the end of each of those days. There we'll recap the big announcements and other highlights for the TechEd event. But don't worry, then the week after TechEd, we're going to return with more Devtoberfest. We have two full more weeks of Devtoberfest content coming your way. And in those 2 weeks, we can particularly cover in detail some of the things that were just announced at TechEd. So you have plenty more time to continue on the Devtoberfest contest. Maybe next week gives you a little chance to catch up on some of the videos that you missed, in addition to tuning in to check out TechEd. So we look forward to seeing you for more weeks of Devtoberfest, as well as the TechEd virtual live online next week. And to tell you more about TechEd, over to you, Josh.
We are days away from coming to you live from the App House in Heidelberg. It's going to be unbelievable. 90-plus sessions, all the developer advocates from around the world, tons of customer and expert speakers all under one roof, but you've got to sign up now. We'll have live keynote analysis, plus live Q&A where you can get answers to your questions in real time or interact with a specific session speaker. Don't miss this chance to take in code demos, live lectures, and virtual workshops. all designed to help you deepen your technical expertise and, most importantly, interact and have fun with our incredible community of thinkers and creators. So, what are you waiting for? Sign up now, and I'll see you online next week.
I'd like to share with you my summary of the top 5 features introduced in the Q3 2024 release of SAP HANA Cloud. First, SAP HANA Cloud now supports vector indexing, which is crucial for efficiently managing and querying large vector datasets. This feature enables faster and more efficient searches, particularly useful for machine learning and AI workloads. Second, the release includes the addition of the HDB scan clustering algorithm, enhancing the capabilities of unsupervised machine learning. This enhancement enables data scientists and application developers using SAP HANA Cloud among you to capture clusters in heterogeneous data and identify groups of similar objects or text documents based on embeddings in vector data. Third, in the SAP HANA native application dev space for SAP Business Application Studio, you can now use the generative AI tools included in SAP Build Code to help you create SQL code based on the prompt you type into the console using natural language. It simplifies query construction and reduces the time required for developing complex data analysis queries. Fourth, in the SAP HANA native application dev space for SAP Business Application Studio, it is now possible to use the SQL notebooks to test your SQL code on SAP HANA Cloud database before you run it productively. And last but not least, there are a lot of important new features in calculation views modeling, and I would recommend reviewing detailed description of all of them in a separate blog post written by product managers. All these features focus on enhancing the efficiency, flexibility, and productivity of data management and analysis within SAP HANA Cloud, offering more advanced tools for developers and data scientists. And if you are looking for what's new in SAP DataSphere in Q3, then product management prepared a separate community call for you to be streamed on October 16th.
This specific news segment is targeted right at our SAP partners. We have a webinar series coming up to help partners who are looking to do their ABAP Cloud certification. This is the certification Backend Developer ABAP Cloud. And in particular, this webinar series is going to help you with content around core ABAP skills, as well as practicing clean core extensibility for SAP S/4HANA. Now, this webinar series is coming up to cover all the materials that I mentioned. It is a multi-day, in fact, four-day webinar series with 3 to 3.5 hours of content each day. This is coming up at the end of October, October 22nd, 23rd, 24th, and October 29th. If you're interested in this kind of content to help you as a partner developer who's looking to update their skills for ABAP Cloud, then check out the link in the description to the Partner Edge portal page with more information about this webinar series.